Okay, so let's try to ask the strategies followed by our guest to complete his CA journey successfully. We'll try to take some planner because we already clearly mentioned that if in case you are not planning for your course, that means you are ready to see the failure results. So let's try to see what are the strategies he has followed, and if in case if something is good for you guys, you can adopt in your study planner. Tribhuvan, you told that you did not plan well, so that is the reason for your failures. So you also told you need to plan on all those things. You just gave it in our previous question. So you can please clearly mention to us what are the strategies you followed, how did you do your plan, study planner, and how convenient or how easy for you to follow that planner.
Yeah, so for what I did was I prepared the plan as per these for month and at the last time of the examination. So then you have to prepare one day in advance what you have to going to do in tomorrow. Now, take one practical subject, take one 20 subjects. Then you should plan that, okay, how many subjects, how many chapters you will complete in a particular day. So in a week you can distribute it in a 6 days. So you have to plan, okay, suppose take from Monday to Saturday, I will study these subjects and this chapter I will complete. And with that, prepare the notes for the chapters also. And you should note down that what is the important keywords in this in those chapters, which you have to revise at the time of examination. And Sunday, what usually I prefer and what I did was, Sunday was for revision purpose.
So whatever you are studying
in the full week, revise that. If that is complete, means okay, whatever you have studied in the last 1 month, revise that. In our professional courses, it is the length of the subject that is difficult. Not like topics are tough or all that. It is the length of the particular subject and the number of subjects. Unless you revise all the things which you have studied, you will forget it. I am giving the example of theory subjects. You should revise all these theory subjects on a regular interval of time. Then you can plan, okay, in next 1 month, what I will complete. Next. Then after that, again, next month. So you should know first how many months you have. Suppose I will take the example of you have 6 months for your exams. Then distribute in like 2 months, and 2 to 1 month. So by the 4th month, you should complete your complete syllabus. Then revision, then doing mock test, then again going for the subjects. If you feel that you are weak in particular subject or particular chapter, again you should concentrate on that subject only. So last 2 months, what you can do is you can make the 2 months for revision and then concentrating on the subject or chapters where you are weak.
Yeah.
And then practical subject also, like same thing, you can make the what I prefer is in a day you can distribute in one practical and one theory subject. Both you can do, means you will not feel bored also, and you have some interest will be there in that. And if you suppose you are thinking if you are not interested in a particular theory subject, so you can leave it apart and you can doing for practical subject also.
Great. Okay, so hope you understood. So the strategy is very simple, as Tribhuvan has already mentioned. You need to plan on a daily basis, alternate day basis, weekly basis, monthly basis. In case if a person is given 6 months to complete any one group or multiple groups based on the plan, whatever you guys have had, you need to ensure that you adhere to the timetable, whatever you have set, whatever you have planned for your studies. So completely ensure that you follow rigorously the timetable provided. You will complete the syllabus before the timing. That's the first point. And second point is you will get sufficient time to know in case if you have not studied any of the topic, or you might be a weak in one or the other topics or subjects, whichever it is. So that you will come to know which and all subjects are strong for you to get more than 50 marks. You will come to know the subjects which you are weak, so that at least you can modify your study pattern to get at least 40 marks. So that you can have a complete study planner based on this. So that don't worry about the syllabus, it is having 1000 pages, 1200 pages, doesn't matter. So condense the topic, understand the topic, so that it becomes easier for you to present it in your examination. So ensure at least last 1 and 1.5 months, as you already mentioned, 2 months also will be a grade which you need to give completely for your revisionary, mock test paper, and any other study material which has institute has released for the upcoming examination. Okay, so Tribhuvan, can you please take us through a study planner for a theory subject and study planner for a practical subject? Because some people might be good in theory and some people might be very good in the practical, but some people might feel difficult to cope up with both the theory and the practical. Can you please help us, our students, to how to manage theory versus the practical? I think this will be it should be based on your experience, whatever you have followed in your CA journey. Yeah.
See, what I have followed in the first, I will go for theory subjects. In theory, what I have done is I have prepared the notes. First thing should be, you should have proper notes. So this is notes only will help you at the time of your examination for the revision. First, to prepare the notes, reduce your full. Suppose if you see the study material of CA or CMA, it is like 1,000 pages, yeah, 1,500 pages. Reduce it to 150 pages, 200 pages in the from the form of notes. So first thing should be in theory subject to prepare the notes. So that from next time you will touch that notes only. You don't need to go for the complete study material. If you have any doubts, then you can refer that. For revision purpose or for future purpose, you should refer that notes only. Then second thing is, once you prepare the notes, you have read a particular chapter, then the main thing in theory subject is proper revision at a regular interval of time. Oh. Unless you revise it properly, you will not remember all the all the topics. Because in CA, if you see in our subjects, company law, income tax, GST, everywhere you have to remember the particular sections also. Okay. It is not easy to remember all the sections unless you revise it properly and regular interval of time. So as I told you previously also, make 1 day in a week for the revision only. And then you have to plan such that when you make the revision, don't make the revision of particular chapter only again and again. You are getting interest in particular chapter, okay, today again I revise this only. Make such like that all the chapters get equal importance in the your revision schedule. And if you go for practical, in practical subject, what I will refer, suggest is, don't go for what I have seen in my friends also. They will go for 3-4 books. They will reference 3-4 books. I will refer the questions in the practical questions in like suppose posting. I will refer this book also, the particular one, study material also. All the 3 books I will solve the question so that I will get a good knowledge. You have to decide one book and go for that only. Once you complete your course, then you can go for practice purpose, you can go for mock test also. There are so many books out there that you can go. Don't go for 2-3 books. Take one particular book. Before you are selecting a particular book, you can take your book. You can ask your seniors also. You can ask your teachers which book is proper. You have to see that book, whether you are okay with the format of that book or not. Once you have selected a book, then stick to that book only. Once complete all full, that particular subject you complete in that book only. Once you complete that, you are little bit, if you get the confidence, then you for solving questions only, you can go for other books. That will be your like coaching center material, where the questions of particular questions will be there, costing questions are there, income tax questions are there. But go for one book only. Even if you are going for coaching student material also, go with that only. But practical subject also, you can perform well if you know the theory of that practical.
Good.
But that theory you should take from one book only. So that step will be there, like you have to follow this first step, second step, third step. So in all the books, they have separate formats to solve the particular questions.
Yeah.
So you will get confused in that. Follow one book. Once you become the expertise, or once you are confident in the particular subject, that yeah, I can now solve the this chapter questions, I can solve now, then you can go for other books also for solving the questions only. Theory will be same in all the books, yes. They will present it in different format. So you will get confusion. So for that particular theory, for that which is required for solving the practical questions, you should stick to one book only. And for solving the question, and then complete your full syllabus from that particular book only, Once you get confidence, then go to the other books or other questions, question mock test paper, previous attempt questions paper, then you can do.
Great. So guys, in case you're wondering, theory subject and confused, it's a boring, practical subject and not good in numbers, so don't worry. So for theory, our guest has already clearly mentioned, as and when you study the new topics, ensure you condense the syllabus, whatever is there in the study material, from 1000 pages to 500 pages, 500 pages to 300 should become 20 or 30 by the time you reach your revisionary stage or revisionary time. Yeah, so plan your theory based on this one. So ensuring the theory matters is your keywords, as our previous guest also mentioned. The keywords are the persons who will help you to get a good marks in theory, not your story. You can write your any of the questions story in 1 or 2 pages, doesn't matter. The examiner will see the keywords. If keywords is keeping him happy, he will give you good marks. If not, one line he will draw and he will tell, okay, this is not a good or a professional way of presenting the contents to the examination or the examiner. Yeah. So for the practical, ensure you don't worry. So I'll be wondering, I'm getting a discount online, I'll order online. So no, don't worry. Once you complete your professional course, what are the investment you are putting now, it will be rewarded to you in a bigger manner. So go to the any of the book centers, see the textbook available for particular practical subjects, see which person is good. See, all the persons are good, all the authors are good. It is depending on you which is a convincing for your purpose. So some author might be writing in a high level which will be not good for you. You can choose a person or the author who are alternatively available for that. Go to the book center, refer that, see that, until you are convinced, do not select any of the author textbooks. So once you are convinced, just pick that book. So you can take help of your teachers, lecturers, coaching centers or your friends or seniors, whoever it is. Take their input, but your decision should be, it's yours. So decide that, follow one book is sufficient for you to qualify your practical subject.